What's going on, guys? Let me start this video with a question. Are you a huge sports fan and do you like going to sports games? Well, today you're in luck because I have a promo code for SeatGeek, which is a ticket sharing app that rates each ticket deal you might come across on a scale of 0 to 10, with 0 being the worst and 10 being the best. Scores more towards 0 show up in red, while scores more towards 10 show up in green. My promo code to get $20 off on SeatGeek is OberSports. You use that code, you get $20 off on any single purchase you want on SeatGeek. With that being said, let's get to the...
All right, what's going on, guys? Coming to you with my reactions to the first game of the season for the Wisconsin Badgers. And I have to say, this was an incredibly dominating performance by this team. Like, I mean, I did not expect that at all, honestly. Like, I kind of came into this game a little bit nervous that the Badgers, you know, might not be up, you know, or not, like, take South Florida too seriously, because, you know, coming into the season, South Florida is, or at least was supposed to be, a good football team. I don't know how good they're going to be this year, but the general consensus was this is a pretty good football team who might compete for a division title in their conference. So, I mean, to come out there, though, and just, like, completely lay waste to them. Like, it's not even a contest, you know? Like, the 49 to nothing. They didn't even get past midfield until, like, 4 minutes left in the fourth quarter. We just completely dominated them, start to finish. And, you know, the driving force, of course, behind that, the two driving forces were Jonathan Taylor, Heisman candidate, and, of course, the Badgers defense, who was phenomenal tonight. I think they had, what, 3 interceptions, a few fumble recoveries. There's the fumble recovery for a touchdown by Hennington. You know, the whole defense played exceptionally well tonight. Lots of sacks, lots of pressure on the quarterback. I loved that. They were getting to him right off the bat in the game, and they were putting pressure on him the entire game. You know, I feel like there wasn't a single drop back where he didn't have to, you know, stand in against a pass rush or something. And that's, you just love to see that, you know. I mean, with that's a great start to the season for the defense, for Taylor. Another guy I want to talk about, Jack Cohn. I'm sure the opinion is going to be mixed on his performance, but to me, I was impressed. He missed 2 or 3 throws all night. Unfortunately, there's the 2 big throws that he missed, the deep shots to Cephas that he overthrew him on both. But, you know, Cohn did exactly what, you know, you want a Badger quarterback to be able to do. He managed the game. He was 19 of 26 for, what was it, 199 yards and 2 touchdowns. He was about as flawless as you could want him to be, with the exception of the 2 missed deep throws. That was it. That was the only bad thing that he did, the only 2 bad things he did all night. And of course, you know, after he missed the first one, people were already calling for them to put Mertz in. And, you know, I hope that Mertz does get a shot at some point in the season, or at least get some playing time. I don't anticipate that he's going to really be the number one guy at all at any point in this season. But, you know, I mean, I definitely wouldn't be opposed to seeing him in later in the season, in one of, like, the last 4 games or something, come in garbage time or whatever, and maybe give him a few throws. But in my estimate, unless Cohn is doing really, really bad, which with what we saw in this game, I don't anticipate, because, like, he was perfectly accurate on throws, you know, 5 to 10 yards down the field. Like, I don't think he missed, like, one of those throws. He was perfect. His accuracy was perfect on those throws. He got the ball to the playmakers, and that's what you want him to do, and he did it. So, really, I don't expect a quarterback change at any point in the season, for those of you who still might be holding out hope that Mertz gets a shot at quarterback 1 this year. But unless there's an injury, I seriously doubt it. So, other than that, I mean, I just can't speak enough to how dominating the Badgers were, though. I mean, they were incredibly tough to, you know, offensively, defensively. And Jonathan Taylor, man, I mean, right now, I know it's week 1, but that dude is the front runner for the Heisman right now. He is the front runner for the Heisman. 4 touchdowns, 183 total yards. The biggest knock on his game coming into the season was his receiving game. People were wondering, can he step up and be a legitimate threat catching the football? He caught two passes for 48 yards and two touchdowns tonight. So I think that kind of addressed that. Obviously, they're probably going to be getting the ball to him even more than that sometime this season. So I'm really looking forward to seeing how Taylor does going forward. And my God, I mean, he really is the front runner right now for the Heisman. And, you know, like I said, it's only week one. Don't want to overreact way too much, but he looked really, really good. We'll see how he does in Big Ten play. I am assuming that he's still going to be dominating as always, but we'll see how much, or even if, his performance drops off against some Big Ten teams. But really liked what I saw from him, liked what I saw from Cone, liked what I saw from the defense. It was an almost perfectly flawless game. The special teams was pretty good. There was a good punt return towards the end by Tyler Dunn, which was something the Badgers sorely lacked last year. They were terrible in punt return situations. Our punter did pretty good, and our new kicker, that was the only spot where I'm like, eh. I mean, he made all of his extra points, but he shanked a 30-yard field goal. So that might leave me a little bit concerned, but, you know, 49-0, there's not a really whole lot of things that you really can be concerned about. So anyways, guys, though, those are my reactions to the game tonight. Let me know what you guys thought in the comment section below. How do you guys think this Badger team is going to do going forward? What do you think their record is going to be after seeing that game? Leave a comment in the comment section down below. Be sure to leave a like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time. Go Badgers!